Related question there. The guy who's pointing at me.
The guy standing up at the
moment. Lecture. Lecture.
Oh, you're next. You're next, Richard.
Lecture's next. Lecture is next.
Question is, are we looking, what sort of facts are we looking for entertainment and experience-wise, and specifically, are we looking towards some content for kids?
I would say, at this point, most things are on the table. Something we talked about doing is sending a survey out once we've sort of reached a certain number of folks to see what people are most interested in. I think it's pretty clear we've sort of been defining tracks, not rigid tracks, but of course there's going to be performances of different types, and gaming, and comedy. And if there is great interest in programming for kids, that is something we consider doing. And yeah, of course we do it in a way that is the JoCo Cruise way of doing it.
Yeah, I don't know how extensive it will be necessarily, but absolutely one of the things we very much have in mind for next year is having some events, some very kid-friendly and kid-oriented events. Absolutely. While we're talking about programming, we talked about it some, but just to very briefly go over the general shape of programming, because one of the big questions is, now that we're on a whole ship, how are we going to have the big show anymore? And the fact of the matter is, the theater on that ship only fits half of the people on the ship.
Which is true for any ship.
Yes.
This is the problem with the ship.
And unfortunately, there's no space on the ship, even up on the pool deck or on the back, that can accommodate the entirety of the ship. So we are expecting to move to a structure of basically two big shows each night. While the early dinner seating is there, the other half will be watching the show, and then everyone will just switch, and that group will eat dinner, and the other group will come and see the show.
It won't necessarily be the same acts early and late show, just because we don't want one group or the other.
Well, we'll discuss that, but...
Certainly
the structure is going to be early show, late show, as far as the big shows are concerned. And then there will be, within that, at other times, a great number of performances going on in all sorts of the other venues on the ship, as well as Shadow Cruise events, and as well as Gaming Track and Event Track events. And the idea is that any performer on the ship in those venues will have multiple opportunities to see them. We'll never always program person X against person Y, so if you like both of them, you'll have an opportunity, at least one opportunity to see each of them. We are also, this may be what we were about to say, we're also very strongly looking into ways when times we are in port to try and have some sort of group-related events, whether those turn out to be a concert or a party or a dance party. We absolutely want to retain the community atmosphere that this event has, and we absolutely want to have events that everybody can all get together and attend.
Beyond that, we're going to be looking into if we can either simulcast the main stage events into the outside stage or other places, or we are going to be giving a TV channel or if we can simulcast it, have them available for replay. And actually the same goes for the ship's music, the PA. All these things are things that we can customize. So we have a lot of fun things already planned that everyone's going to experience things together, even if we're not going to be in one grand venue.
You're going to wake up every morning at 6 a.m. with my voice in the
But we put off Redshirt for far too long.
Oh, and on the subject of full ship customizations, I mean, just imagine...
Richard.
My question is, we rarely see any one of us in the gamble, in the casino. Might we talk to the cruise line about giving those folks a week off during that time?
The question is, do we necessarily need there to be a casino, or can it be used for gameplay? There actually are a lot of Sea Monkeys interested in gaming, in wagering gaming, and that is something that we think more people might be if it's an environment where it's all us. But we definitely have plans for expanding the number of places for gaming. For example, I don't know, the entire main dining room until dinner time? That's something that the ship has already said is a possibility for us to do, and that's something that we will be doing. We do these visits to the ship where we sail and look at the spaces. We've walked on the Western Dam several times. Of course, we sailed in 2012, but we're going to be doing a couple of trips to really look at the spaces and figure out, all right, how can we do those things?
Drew, do you have something to say about cultural?
Just imagine, not even just these big shows, how much more we'll be able to do with simulcasting, but like the little venues, like being able to really, we can really take each one of those and do a custom show, like an amazing performer you like would actually be surprised to show up in a piano bar. Like there are all these opportunities for these little organic things because the ship is entirely ours. And on the subject of additional gaming spaces, imagine that a portion of a windjammer were gaming, for example.
And also many
more. Not accepting it, apparently.
And then more
performers.
We definitely want to keep the ratio of, you know, number of people who are attending and performers to be the same or better than the 7th.